Well, in other news, I accidentally bought a humidor off eBay. Kind of moron am I? You're thinking, Kelly's nuts. Accidentally bought a humidor off eBay? Yeah, I was walking through my room when I had an auction up, and I had a glass of water in my hand. I tripped and spilled the water, and one of the ice cubes hit the buy button on eBay and bought this humidor. Yeah, that's what happened. No. What happened was, I've never had a nice wooden humidor. I've had my, if you watch my videos and you saw my video on cigar humidors, I have a nice Pelican case, which I've used for many years now. And before that, I had other various airtight containers. As my cigar collection grew, I got bigger containers. In fact, I've got a Pelican case that is about 3 feet long now. 3 by 2.5 by about a foot, which is, it doesn't currently have cigars in it, but I hope someday it will be full of cigars. Right now I'm pretty much out of cigars. But I was looking, as I've done many times, at humidors on eBay. I spent all night looking at humidors on eBay. I haven't been to bed yet, as a matter of fact. But I don't sleep very well. But anyway. So I'm looking at these humidors, and I found one I really, really liked. It wasn't quite as big as I wanted to have it, but so I spent hours looking for one like that, only bigger. The one I liked is like a 75 count humidor, 50 to 75, you know, cigar humidor. It's about 10 inches by 9 inches by 4.5, which it turned out suit me just fine, because I'm not going to put all my cigars in. I'm just going to put those cigars which I currently am smoking. And I decided not to buy it. I decided to wait and see if it's a Cigar Star brand humidor, which I don't know if it's good or not. I think they actually are good. There's videos on YouTube. I think they actually are a pretty good company. I don't know. It's not an expensive humidor. And they're from Canada. And this was from Canada, this humidor. And the price was $153 Canadian dollars. So I'm like looking at this thing. I looked all around and I found another humidor very much like it, which was like 190 something. I could probably get it for like 179 or something. That was bigger. That was like 180 count humidor, but it wasn't quite as nice looking. It didn't have the nice colors this has. This humidor I'm talking about, you'll see it. It's kind of a. It looks very much like an LA Blue Paraquat humidor. I've always wanted one of those, but never could afford one. Someday, LA Blue for me. Someday. So I'm looking at this thing today, and I noticed the one. There's one of them online on eBay that has a buy it now thing. It has a price of $153 Canadian. Then it has a buy it now. It has a make it or make an offer. And I was really tired, and I was looking, and I thought, you know, I really would like to have a humidor. I mean, I'm pretty much flat broke right now, so I can't afford a humidor. But I thought, you know, I wonder what they really want for this thing. If they got to make an offer on it, they probably would take less. So in my sleepless stupor, I put an offer in of $100 on it, $100 Canadian, which is about $97 American, thinking they would write back and say, no, we'll take $125, in which I would say, no, I can't pay that, I just can't afford it, I don't have the money. So so I put the $100 offer in, and I go through the whole process, and I click, you know, buy or whatever, you know, offer or whatever. And immediately I get a screen that says, they have accepted your offer. You bought the humidor. I'm like, shit, I don't have the money. Evidently they have this thing set up to where that they will automatically accept offers, you know, above a certain range. And I was like, holy shit, where am I going to get the money? I actually had to take a bunch of change out of my change jar and go down and cash it in. How embarrassing. So, the next thing, I do that, and then I'm thinking, Jesus, what a moron. I mean, I've been an antique dealer, and I bought and sold things, and I was a commodity trader, and all sorts of things in my life that all deal with being able to negotiate deals. I'm you may not know this, but I'm very good at negotiating deals of all kinds. Friends come to me and ask me to negotiate deals for them, and I'm thinking, Jesus, I should offer 75, you know. maybe they would have taken that, for Christ's sake. And of course, maybe $100 being an even number was their low. Maybe I hit it right on the money, I don't know. But I'm thinking, geez, I left $25 on the table, what a moron. Plus, I didn't really intend to really buy it, which is, of course, I completely stupid, because as it says on eBay, if you click that button, you know, you're intending to buy it. And usually that's the way it is. If I buy something, I might buy it. But anyway, so I bought a humidor accidentally. But you know, it's a beautiful humidor. And even though I like to have one that holds like 150 to 180 cigars, first of all, I don't have that many cigars. I'm pretty much out of cigars. I bought about 5-6 cigars last night at the local. And I've got 23 cigars coming, 22 cigars coming from GR in 5-packs. What I'm going to do with this humidor is just use this for cigars that I'm actually going to smoke, like grab and smoke on a regular basis. Anyway, how foolish, but how cool. This is a beautiful humidor, by the way. It's not a, you know, an expensive humidor, but it is a beautiful humidor. You'll see it. I'll show it to you. It's for my first wood humidor. You know, I can get a bigger one someday. You know, but for right now, it'll work pretty good. All right, folks. Thanks for listening. Talk to you later.